All right. Shalom, shalom. First and foremost, we want to give all praises, honor, and glory to
Yahweh,
double honors to our apostles and elders, a great millstone who rule well and taught us this truth, and peace and salutations to Akim that's pushing this word throughout the four corners abroad with truth and sincerity. And shalom to the Akim Wa Athwats, the brothers and sisters that's tuning in, studying, and listening on the vibration of Yahweh Bashim Yahushar. Yahweh is who the world ignorantly calls the Most High God and Heavenly Father. And Yahweh means he is, he exists, he is to be. Bahashem means in the name. Yahweh Shai is who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. And Yahweh Shai means he's the Savior, he's the Deliverer. And Bahashem in the name, Rakah Kadosh, the Spirit Holy of the Holy Spirit. We're just two brothers out of the GMS Boston camp. I'm the brother Tazer War.
Banuol.
And we're back here with another lesson. As we have here on the screen, we have an article I have from InfoWars. The headline reads, "The police state is coming for religious extremists, evangelical Christians, pro-life activists, and libertarians. You know, so that just proves that, hey, we're in the time of Jacob's trouble that's going to be coming to you Israelites. And that dwells here in America. There's going to be a time of trouble like no other. You know, Esau Edom is going to come down with great wrath because he knoweth that he had but a short time, because the truth is now being manifest. And there's a quote, you know, the truth, when you speak the truth, is going to be deemed as hate speech, because the ones that's in power, the ones that's in rulership, you know, they're trying to keep their plans, their agendas, and the way that they move in secrecy. And, you know, they don't want to get exposed. So they're going to come with laws and decrees to pretty much quiet this truth and this information from being spread noise abroad. But through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, you know, we are made enemies to the world because we're not of the world. And this is what we've been prophesying. And this is part of the downfall of America and Esau Edom's kingdom, man.
Yeah, basically, if I may, real quick, right? This devil, they know fully that they cannot establish the new world order with the prophet on the scene, right? So before they can partially implement the new world order, they pretty much have to come after the men of the Lord. You know what I'm saying? That's exactly what it is. And this devil is, you know, Joe Biden, ever since he got into office, he's been citing executive order like never seen before. So best believe we are among the people that they're going to come after in the article. Pretty much the title of the article speak for itself, man. These devils, they have declaring war against all people, against us, especially us in the know, those of the circumcision. Because this devil, now he's backed up in a corner. So the only thing that he has to rely on is to be violent, you know, to bring forth the sword. You know what I'm saying? That's right. His blessing. And that's exactly, that's his true nature, to come against the sword, because his law, his legislation that he has on the book, it's pretty much to come against us. Why? Because the doctrine that we're pushing is against his against his agenda.
That's right.
His system. So it's gonna have to come against us, which is ultimately that's a biblical prophecy. You know,
Khan, I got the definition on Wikipedia. I searched up Project Megiddo, and it was a report researched and written by the United States Federal Bureau of Investigation under Director Louis Free. Released on October 20th, 1999, the report named followers of white supremacist Christian Identity, the American Militia Movement, quote-unquote, black Hebrew Israelites, and apocalyptic cults as potential terrorists who might become violent in reaction to the new millennium.
Yeah, basically, anybody that's believed in a higher power is a threat to Esau's rulership, man. Is a threat to Esau's new world order agenda, man.
That's
exactly why he's going to come after us, because we prophesizing his downfall.
That's right.
You know, he best believes they don't like that. You know what I'm saying? They don't like that. They want everybody to pretty much lay down or get down. You know what I'm saying? So that's exactly what it is, if I'm saying it correctly. You know what I'm saying? Anybody that pretty much come against this devil is going to come against you and put you to death, man. But to worry about Shem Yashai, the Lord has reserved to himself 7,000 men who's not going to bow the knees to the image of Baal. So guess what? The Lord has a remnant that is going to save and they're not going to submit to this devil's agenda, you know?
That's right. So when you see black Hebrew Israelites, you know, hey, we're deemed that as a potential threat to society, you know, terrorists, as they deemed on their reports. And, you know, that's part of the persecution that's coming, gonna happen, that's going to, that's what's prophesied and written about in the Bible. You know, our Lord and Savior, Yahushua, was persecuted for righteousness' sake. So we, you know, the servant is not greater than the master. So we're going to have to go through the same persecution in these times. So I want to start off with Matthew 5. And I'll start at verse 10. Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are ye when men shall revile you and persecute you, and shall say all manner of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. See, so that's the... This is what's coming to you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans that believe in the Bible. Best believe that you, the Hebrew Israelites from Great Millstone to all these other ABC camps, all these other Hebrew Israelite camps, they're on a file as deemed as terrorists. We're going to be the face or the new boogeyman of terror throughout the world, and mainly here in America, because Esau Edom controls the media. They control the news outlets. You know, they can portray anybody for being evil, and it can portray anybody for being a hero. And they're going to use, as we read in Project Megiddo, anybody that's believing in apocalyptic endings. You know, the Bibles, which was talks about the downfall of America and the downfall of Esau Edom, pretty much going to look at as these guys are the terror of the earth, man. So we're going to be persecuted for righteousness' sake, because we believe in the truth and we believe in righteousness under Yahweh Bashem Al-Rashad.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is, man. And that's exactly the time we're in. This devil's day. They pretty much, Esau pretty soon is going to show his horn, man. For our people who doesn't think that this devil is a devil, guess what? Pretty soon you're going to realize it, man. You're going to realize it, but ultimately it's going to be too late, man.
That's
exactly what it is, man. So that's a beautiful thing, right? If we get persecuted for righteousness' sake, that's mean we are number, Lord willing, we're number among the prophets, man.
That's
the prophets
right.
of all, they always prophesied the downfall of kingdoms, man.
That's right.
And this is nothing new. We have been prophesizing, stung the elder apostles and down, you know, they have been doing it for the longest, right? 30 plus years, and we are pretty much following their footsteps. So
that's
we
right.
have pretty much pushing the vibration of the downfall of this place, man. And ultimately, that's the downfall of Esau. Pretty much, downfall of America is pretty much the Esau pretty much going down. It's not gonna come to power never ever again, man.
Kind. You know? That's why the scripture says rejoice and be exceedingly glad, you know. This is what we've been prophesying for. This is what we've been working for. You know, just like the days of old when Paul and John, they were put into prison for preaching the name of Yahweh Shai. They were rejoicing. They were happy for receiving that pretty much that short tribulation for righteousness' sake. So that's why we have to be rejoicing exceedingly glad, because our reward is in heaven. And we pray that we, you know, we endure to the end, because we know, you know, we're going to be brought in front of their kings and their nobles and you know, and you know, their princes in the synagogues, you know, and we might be put to death or beheaded because we don't refuse to submit to their kingdom, man, to their agenda, which is the RFID microchip, you know, submit to the beast, you know. So we know our tribulation must come, and we got to go through that suffering, you know. So just seeing this as the headline just proves that they're really going to target men believing in the Bible and the black, so-called black Hebrew Israelites. We know we're not black. We are different shades of brown. You know, we know Israelites contain of so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. So, you know, these are God's chosen people. So again, Esau Edom is the is adverse to Yahweh and his chosen people. He's the main enemy. So he's definitely going to come down with ways to try to persecute us and destroy us as a nation.
So 2 Timothy 3 and 12. Yea, in all that will live godly in Yahamashiach Yahweh Shai shall suffer persecution.
That's right.
And that's exactly what it is. We're rehearsing the righteous act. We're being brotherly. We're being looking out to one another. And we're rehearsing the righteous act of Yahweh Hashem Shai. And that's exactly what makes us a threat. We are the biggest threat to Esau's rulership. His New World Order agenda, like we said before, he can't establish his New World Order with the prophet on the scene, man. And that's exactly how... why he's gonna have to remove us from the corner. We're not gonna be out there on the highway in the byways pretty much teaching the Bible, because that's gonna be pretty much hate speech, man, you know, against his against going against the grain, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Which ultimately gonna lead up to the female of the world, man. You know, that's exactly where we're heading into, man, you know?
That's right. Yeah, this is good point. This is an agenda for them to remove anybody that believes in the Bible. So like the brother says, a famine of the word. You want to get that real quick? There's Amos
8:11, right?
Yeah, Khan.
I'll get it for you.
Khan. So this is why, you know, we're here to give this warning, continue to do lessons. Hey, we're giving these devils no rest. We're constantly making the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai and preaching this gospel until these crackers, these devils, pretty much come down with that wrath, man, and come down and remove the prophets and censor everybody, because we know it's the truth, man. And it's part of prophecy. The Lord is have his service to prophets out on the highways and byways and uploading his lessons, pretty much calling out to you Israelites, man, to get right and repent before these the evil days come nigh, man.
Come, so Amos 8:11. Behold, the days come, saith the Lord power, that I will send a famine in the land, not a famine of bread, nor thirst for water, but of hearing of the word of the Lord.
That's right. You want to continue?
But and they shall wander from sea to sea, and from the north even to the east.
Yeah.
They shall run to and fro to seek the word of the Lord, and they shall not find it.
See, so this word, these prophets, the gospel is going to be made scarce at the end times. So, and we can see with just this headline that they're pushing their agenda to remove the word of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, because this gospel is a threat of pretty much the elites establishing their new world order. You know, the elites are not going to allow the prophets to say, don't take the RFID chip, it's the mark of the beast, while they're trying to implement it and trying to push it as a good thing throughout the world. You know, we are the biggest threats to the elites, because we don't care about, you know, the blue collar everyday working Edomite. We care about those that's in the high places, them global elitists, man.
Yeah, and ultimately that's a form of censorship to pretty much get rid of our free speech altogether.
That's right.
Because the Lord pretty much paved the way for us to the free speech that these devils came up with,
on
1776.
On
pretty much, yeah, it's pretty much was a way for us to bring out this word, man. The Lord make it a way for us to be out there and push this gospel. You know what I'm saying? So now the gospel is being reached to the four winds of the earth. Now they are about to put it into it. Ultimately, that's prophecy, you know?
That's right. So we're going to go to this article. The headline reads, the police state is coming for religious extremists, evangelical Christians, pro-life activists, and libertarians by Michael Snyder. You just can't be against political violence when it's the other side does it. Hey, it's the truth, man. It just shows the other side, which is the government, is doing these, is causing nothing but chaos and violence throughout the world, man. It says, if you cherish faith, family, and freedom, you might want to keep a low profile for a while. The Domestic Terrorism Prevention Act of 2021 has been unveiled in Congress, and it has bipartisan support.
Yeah, because like this devil, Joe Biden, is the one pretty much, we told you that Joe Biden gonna be worse than Donald Trump, man. Joe Biden is the perfect vessel pretty much to push forward the agenda of the globalists, the agenda of the New World Order, man, to pretty much get rid of free speech, censorship, and right, pretty much collapse society, because they pretty much gave up on America, man. They pretty much want to establish a cashless society, bring forth the RFID microchip. The RFID microchip going to be the new currency of the world to come, man. And these devils, they want to, America is the last stronghold. They want to get rid of America altogether in free speech, in gun laws.
Yeah. That's
what Joe Biden was set up to do, man.
Yeah, the first two amendments is pretty much has to be brought and down for the elites to establish that new world order agenda, man. Because they don't want, again, people speaking out against them, and they don't want people fighting back and being resistance toward them, you know?
That's right, cool.
Continuing on, it is essentially the Patriot Act on steroids. And we were being told that it almost certain that some version of the legislation will make it to Biden's desk for him to sign. Personally, I am very much against all forms of domestic terrorism, and a law which could help to prevent terror attacks from happening is going to sound like a good thing to a lot of people.
And that's exactly how you know this thing that took place in, was it 9/11? Capitol Hill. That was a setup, you know what I'm saying? That was a way for them to pretty much come against us, you know what I'm saying? They used this event that took place as a way to pretty much bring forth an executive order to come after the middle of the Lord, man.
That's right. And that's why they got National Guard and FEMA troops out and employed in the Capitol. You know, they're ready to pretty much use their military might and power to pretty much stop rioting, stop uproars, pretty much shutting people up and putting fear. If you speak out against the government, that you may lose, you know, your freedom, may lose your life, you know. Mm-hmm. And this is what their plans are, man. Mm-hmm. And now they're gonna target, you know, those that believe in. It's a pro life. This is how you know these guys are the devils. You against people that's pro life, man. You against people that speak against that speak. Teaching the Bible, peace is righteousness. Yeah. And this land was found. They say it's founded off the laws of the land or laws of the Bible. Mm-hmm. You know, they make you take an oath and swear with your right hand on the Bible. So you know, so why are you against the men that teach out of the Bible? It just proves that this country and this nation and the rulers of this country are hypocritical nation, man. They're devils, man.
Yeah, and it shows you too that it shows you also that, right, what we're saying are the truth. You know what I'm saying? Because if they come against us, that's mean what we're saying is against them. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
And that's exactly when you read Psalms 50 verse 16, but unto wicked the Most High said, what has thou to do to declare my statue? Because these devils, they like to portray to the whole world America as a Christian nation. They believe on the biblical principle of the Bible.
That's
but
right.
Meanwhile, they go against everything that the Lord Yahweh Shimshai says not to do, man.
Kind of, I'll get that real quick. Psalms 50 and verse 16, but unto the wicked the Most High said, what has thou to do to declare my statutes? Or that thou shouldest take my covenant in thy mouth, seeing thou hatest instruction and castest my words behind thee.
Yeah, these devils, they hate instruction, man. They goes back to Cain. Cain gave up a fucked up sacrifice, though he know what he was supposed to do. You know what I'm saying? It's in this devil's spirit to pretty much be rebellious, to go against everything that the Lord says not to do, man. And that's exactly their characteristic. But they like to portray to the whole world that they are equitable, they are generous, they are fair. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
To deceive the masses of people, man.
That's right.
You know, that's exactly why we call it the devil, the wicked, you know?
Yeah, and that's why they're using these buzzwords. And as I read in Project Megiddo, you can also read in Rex 84. You know, these all other documents and what's up?
You got more on that, bro.
Yeah, legislations and stuff that they're really going to come down on righteous people, man. They're going to come down and persecute the Hebrew Israelites, man. And this is our warning, because we are the true Hebrew Israelites that the Bible speaks of, you know, and we're here to teach the truth. So this is what we've been warning. Hey, you got to get your mind and prepared and be ready for when Esau Edom comes down. You got to always know, say, 10 steps ahead of your enemy, man.
Mm-hmm.
We can see it. We're not ignorant of his devices, man.
Oh.
But continuing on, Psalms 50 verse 18, when thou sawest a thief, then thou condescended with him,
mm-hmm,
and has been partaker with adulterers,
mm-hmm,
thou givest thy mouth to evil and thy tongue frameth deceit.
And this article is a perfect example on how they give their mouth to evil, man.
That's
they
right.
Pretty much set up snares and nets to pretty much come against us. They're gonna accuse us in the media, make it seem like we're the boogeyman, with the bad guys, you know what I'm saying? And all we do, in reality, all we do is teaching the Bible,
man.
Teaching the truth, man. But the truth is not profitable to these devils, man. And George Orwell says, in a time of universal deceit, telling the truth becomes a revolutionary act, man. And that's exactly what it is, man. These devils, they hate the truth because the whole system, the whole agenda is based on lies, deception, and wickedness, you know?
Hey, can you give me Luke 21? Could start at verse 12.
It's Luke chapter 21, verse 12, and it says, but before all these, they shall lay their hands on you,
yeah,
and persecute you, delivering you up to the synagogues and into prison, being brought before kings and rulers for my name's sake.
See, so this is prophecy. This is the Lord Yahweh Shai speaking in red letters. He's warning his apostles and also pretty much the prophets of today. Hey, just because what you're doing, what we're doing is prophesying, and we're speaking out against the kings and rulers of this world. Hey, we're going to be they're going to lay out their hands upon us and throw us and persecute us in the city, throw us in the synagogues and in these prisons. Hey, this is why you see, you know, these FEMA camps throughout the whole world, you know, these Walmarts being ready to be filled up with you Jakes, man. You know, we're going to be brought for the kings and rulers for Yahweh's sake, man. So this is prophecy, you know. Best believe the FBI, the CIA, all these alphabetical boys, man, they have each and every one brother that teach this truth, and everybody that clicked and even heard or even believed, you know, best believe they have them on a file as a potential terrorist or threat of society, man.
Yeah, that's why they have a yellow list, the red list, you know what I'm saying, that's the right. Blue list. They know that there are certain men that they cannot be brought. So the last solution, the last thing to do to them is to put them to death. Verse 13, and it shall turn to you for testimony. Settle therefore in your heart not to meditate before what you shall answer.
That's right.
For I will give you a mouth and wisdom which shall your adversary shall not be able to gainsay nor resist.
Keep reading, bro.
And ye shall be betrayed both by parents and brethren and kinsfolk, mm-hmm, and friends, and some of you shall be caused to be put to death, and ye shall be hated of all men for my name's sake.
And that's the point right there. You know, while just like articles like this, and best believe when they put it on their main media, like on their CNNs and their Fox News and their CNBCs, so on and so forth, of the Hebrew Israelites, these are the threats, just like they did with 9/11. Once that event happened, you know, they were quick to say, the Osama bin Laden was the fault, you know, and they had his face and Al-Qaeda
blasting all over the world,
throughout news, mm, articles, newspapers, throughout the whole world. And they went for retaliation. Mm. So best believe when they do that, say they could do a false flag event and blame it on the Hebrew Israelites. And once they put it on the news, the same way how they did Al-Qaeda, you know, Osama bin Laden, you know, just best believe even your family, your friends, they're going to give you up.
That's right. That's
they're
right.
Going to give you up.
That's right.
And pretty much sell you out. And they're going to pretty much sell you out. You know, tell the authorities pretty much where you live, where you stay. You know, and that just proves that you're going to be betrayed by all men for my man's sake.
Yeah, your family member are going to be the one pretty much giving you out. You know what I'm saying? Because hey, they're going to be like, oh, I know that was something wrong with him. I know he was out there teaching about the Bible, being on the corner street, you know what I'm saying? Oh, telling the white man's a devil. You know what I'm saying? They pretty much, your own family member are going to be the one that's going to allow this devil to come after you, you know?
Yeah, so see, articles like this is going to cause just more persecution. We know it's false information that these devils are playing to try to stop this word from coming out and try to remove the prophets out of the streets. But as the scripture says, they can't do nothing for the truth. Against the truth, but for the truth, man. So we're just going to, you know, keep it short and brief, but it just proves that these guys are the devils and we're not ignorant of Satan's devices, man.
Come on.
So with that, man, we pray everything was edifying. Lord will, we leave this article, this link in the description box, and we want to give all praise, honor, and glory to
Yahweh Shema Shabbat Shema Kakadash.
Shalom.
Shalom.